In class 11 business studies, we are on chapter number 11, that is international trade, or we can say export and import. So international business. In this chapter, I already just completed the difference between domestic trade and international trade. This is international. National trade. International trade. And then we completed the modes of entry into international business, benefits of international business. And in entry in international business is with the help of various modes. Already we completed in this chapter, already we completed the various modes of entering into international business, like licensing and franchising. Okay, already we completed the various modes like export and import. And then on that day, I told you that one new advanced way of entering into international trade is wholly owned subsidiaries. This is a new term for you. Wholly owned subsidiaries is a latest way of entering into international business. In this system, the holding company, or we can say parent company, acquires 100% shares in a subsidiary company. 100% shares in a subsidiary company means the main company, which is we can say parent company, takes up the 100% share in another company or subsidiary company. So this is the way of wholly owned subsidiary method. It can be established in two ways. Set up new firms in a foreign country. Okay? Set up new firms in a foreign country means in other country you can set up your own firm and acquire an existing firm in a foreign country. Acquire an existing firm means the parent company will buy any running or existing firm in another country. So wholly owned subsidiary means buy the 100% shares of another company which is situated in other country, or that is by two ways: set up new firm, okay, or acquire already running firm in the foreign country. Now what are the advantages? Full control over operation, because you are buying 100% shares in that company. So there will be full control, and trade secrets will not be lost because no one is there to share the secrecy as well as share the profits. Okay, so trade secrets will not be lost. That will be continued with the same firm because they own 100% shares. Now disadvantages. That is the major disadvantage, I can tell you. Huge investment. Without investment, how can a company can buy another running firm? With huge investments, that is possible. But see, this is the drawback. So we can say this is not suitable for small and medium-sized business. No sharing of loss. If there will be loss, maybe some non-resident institution. Then no one will be there to share your loss because you have 100% shares. That's why you have to deal with the 100% loss. Then not allowed by some countries. This is the drawback we can see. Few countries are there in the world which are not allowed anyhow, any other way to enter into that country. Okay. So that is the drawback of wholly owned subsidiary, because that is the fear in their mind that the new firm will take over 100% share. Now next, What is the export and import process? When I told you the mode of entry into international business, in that part I told you there is some process, some paper formalities are there. If you want to export to other countries, you have to follow some process, some rules. Okay, so today we will discuss first of all that is export process. One by one I am going to tell you, then you will be able to write down the answer. Export process. How one person who wants to export can start this business. Like from Kota, Kota store, Kota sari can be exported. From India, jewels, spices, various things, silk, now these are export to other countries, these all things are export. Then how one can start? First of all, the receipt of inquiry, that is, and sending quotation. See, the person who wants to import will send you the inquiry. First of all, in international business, he will see the details through online mode, internet way, and first of all, receipt of inquiry means he will send the inquiry. Okay? Send the inquiry means he will ask about quality, rate, terms and conditions, and he wants to know what are the variety and all other things. So the exporter gets an inquiry from the buyer from a foreign country. Okay, this is receipt of inquiry. Receipt of inquiry means he wants to know what are the things you are supplying, what are the variety, quality, quantity, etc. Then sending quotation. Then what the importer, exporter will do? First, he will check the inquiry. Accordingly, he will send the answers in the quotation form, in which he will explain the types, varieties, quantity, quality, terms and conditions. It is also known as performa invoice. Okay. Now, it contains all descriptions about the product, such as price, quality, size, grade, weight, mode of delivery, terms and conditions, payment terms. Then first step is receipt of inquiry, means the exporter will receive the inquiry, then he will send the answer in the form of quotation. Then when he sends the quotation with the complete detail of price, quality, size, quantity, etc. Then receipt of order or invoice. If the buyer is satisfied with the conditions in the performa invoice, if the buyer who is sitting in some other country will be satisfied, then he will place the order. When he will place the order, this order is called invoice. Okay, see, in domestic trade, if the buyer will send the order to the seller, this is simply order of goods. But in international trade, this order is known as indent, and it contains the description of goods, price, quality, etc. Okay, this is receipt of order. In India, the importer will send you the complete detail what he wants, what is the description of price, quality, quantity, goods, etc. Okay. Then for assessing importer's creditworthiness and securing a guarantee for payment. In export process, the importer will send the indent. Now the turn is from the point of view of exporter. He wants to know the security, safety of payment. This is the main fear every exporter will have. See, before sending the goods, he will conduct an inquiry about the financial capacity of the importer to ensure the promptness in the payment settlement. Okay? See, exporter will not send the goods immediately. First of all, he will check the credit worthiness, ability of making payment, and then he will secure a guarantee for payment. Usually, exporter may demand a LOC, letter of credit. For that, importer will take the letter of credit from his banker. Then bank is giving assurance to the exporter about the payment settlement. Then what is LOC? Letter of credit. Letter of credit is a guarantee given by the importer's bank that it will honor payment up to a specified amount of export bills to the bank of the exporter. This is the guarantee paper. We can say it is issued by the bank of importer and he will give in assurance of payment that he will make the payment. If the importer will not the payment, make the payment, then the bank is giving assurance. Okay. Now, obtain export license. Now the process starts. Because, see, after satisfying and taking assurance of the payment, the next step is apply for license. Now, to get the export license from the import export licensing authority, the exporter has to fulfill certain formalities. Export license, export import license number. So in every country there is some office for foreign trade in India that is also there, Directorate General of Foreign Trade, in which export import license number has to be applied. So what are the formalities for this licensing? Open a bank account. First of all, the export-import license is possible only when the person first has a bank account. Then obtaining import-export code. Just now I told you IEC number. Export-import code number is issued by the Directorate General of Foreign Trade or Regional Import Export Licensing Authority. This is known as Import Export Code. It is issued by the authorities, government authorities. Okay. Then registering with appropriate export promotion councils. See, in India, as well as in other countries also, they have made some councils. Like Apparel Export Promotion Council for leather exports, for spices, for sugar, for tea, coffee, and jute, etc. So there are various councils are there. Okay. So accordingly, the person who is exporting, who is doing international business, will apply and get registered in this council. Then registering with Export Credit and Guarantee Corporation, ECGC, to cover the risk of non-payment. This is also necessary. See, if the importer is not making the payment, then there is the risk. I know that letter of credit giving assurance, but also the ECGC, Export Credit and Guarantee Corporation, is there to cover the risk of non-payment. So they gave some assurance to the exporter. Then fifth step. Now the license is over. So the next step is obtaining pre-shipment finance. Now this step is related with the money. See, first of all, he received inquiry, then sending quotation, then getting intent, then getting letter of credit, then receiving export, import license. Okay, see, just now I told you now, he will have to get export import code. This is the unique code. Like in you have ATM code and etc. Same way, import export code is there. So after completing all the formalities, now he has to start the payment production. He has to start the production because now he will send to the importer, then he will get the payment. So obtaining pre-shipment finance. Now the process is to get the money. Because he has to start the production. So obtaining pre-shipment finance means after the confirmation of order, complete formalities, the exporter now approach to his bank for getting finance, which is known as pre-shipment finance, because he will start the production and to carry out export production. Okay, so he will start the production. Now, after getting finance, one by one, you cannot jump any step. Okay, so after getting finance, now what the exporter will do? Now the exporter is ready and he will make the product or the production or the goods as per specification, as per India, as per order, or maybe he will purchase it, he will produce it. Procurement means he will purchase from the market and then send to the other countries. It depends on the intent. If he is the producer, he will produce the goods. And if he is intermediary, then he will purchase from some other and send it to importer. Then pre-shipment inspection. See, in foreign trade, the quality of goods must conform to the international standard because this is the prestige point for the country also and the image. So for this compulsory inspection is there and the government of India's department, Export Inspection Agency will do that. Other steps we will do later on today, we have to complete up to here. See, what I have told you just now, that export process is having some specific steps. Okay, so first of all, receipt of inquiry and sending invitation. This is the first step, that from foreign country, randomly some person wants to inquire, wants to know the information, what the products you are making, then the person who is sitting in another country will send the information about the price, quality, size, quantity, weight, design, lighting, etc. Then, after sending this quotation, or the person who is sitting in other country will place an order in which he will give the answers of the same description of the same, like what are the goods, what are the price, quality, quantity, design, variety, terms and conditions, and he will place the order. Then the order is known as intent. Okay, now because you got the intent, now the exporter wants to get the assurance about the product, about the product's payment, about the payment, then he will require the knowledge about the credit worthiness of importer, and because he wants to get the complete credit worthiness capacity of the importer and payment security, guarantee for payment, then he demands that he demands a letter of credit from the importer who is sitting in another country. That person will send the LOC. Letter of credit means that it is issued by the bank that they will give us the pay. After letter of credit, now he is satisfied with that LOC, so that the person who wants to export will apply for export license. That license can be applied in import-export licensing authority. Okay, that authority will take some formalities, some charges also, and after satisfying, they will issue IEC, import-export code number. Okay, then that will be issued by the Directorate General or by the regional authority. Then the next step for getting license is to register in the council. There are various councils specifically related with the products. Then Credit and Guarantee Corporation is there to cover the risk. And the exporter now start to make the goods according to the specification. So he will start the production, but before starting, he has some finances. So he will apply for finance. When getting the finance sources, now he is ready to produce the goods according to the order, procurement of goods. When he produces the goods, then the next step is inspection. So this is the matter of pride or matter of, we can say that an image of the country. So the goods can be according to the order that should be followed, some standards also. Okay, so inspection is to be performed. So today we completed this part.